I would like to ask you, first of all, if you had to describe Asia art scene or Japan art scene in one word, what would you say?
It's a quite an interesting question because I just using this metaphor as a kind of situation it's covered by an iceberg, but then underneath there is some kind of very strong kind of magma, mm-hmm. to something like that. It's kind of hot because those kind of magmas are coming from the 1980s. Because the 80s in Japan is quite strong, and economically, also globally, and a strong impact. Also, lots of kind of, remixes and, cultural remixes and we happen. Also, lots of kind of intercourse between subculture and also high art. So that's 80s and quite strong in Japan. But then many artists now is start referring on the 80s and. Some of the artists and also started a kind of connection with some function of the society. For instance, some artists very concerned about the infographic. Also, the other artists very much interested to create a public space and working with the architect. Mm-hmm. So this is it's a quite very interesting time and Japanese art facing on.
How would you describe the art scene now in Japan? How do you see the post-Murakami generation, and what kind of artists would you like to suggest to us today? For example, artists you have worked with closely recently, for example.
Yeah, because on that very question, I mentioned two artists and three artists, if I say, because one artist and it's Lightomatics. Lightomatics is the artist Daito Manabe, and he just formed a group of the people because Daito Manabe and he studied computer programming, mm-hmm. also video art. So he's very much strongly has a concept and so try to realize his concept into the very radical way. And through the computer programming, for instance, he designed a stage set and Perfume. Perfume is very famous, and a kind of techno pop group. So it's a worldwide is very famous. But then he just make and for instance, and he make a very special kind of stage design for Perfume because and he just put a drone, from the drones and the cameras and drones and the shooting and their performance from the top. That's at the beginning. He did it 4 years ago. It's very mm-hmm. early. Also, he just make a system and a very design application. He just distributed those applications, the audience downloading. He just make a very special costume and a perfume. Perfume wears a white costume. Mm-hmm. But one by one, and audiences and just make a design, their costume in their concert hall. That are using a special design appli, they send it. But then one by one, one moment, and their design reflecting the perfume costume on the stage. Because everybody can participate in designing the kind of the singer's costume. This is a system. So this is for instance, this is very successful in the entertainment world. But also, he's quite very radical ideas. For instance, he made a piece and named the trader because for my exhibition he made that trader is infographic visualization of the data of the trading and stock market because he just connected live information stock market one by one and all the information has situation has been changing and he just designed a very beautiful and moving infographic in the museum space because this is a kind of amazing situation because this is almost a secret part is stock market because that domain the world also economy governance because those are special kind of influential data could be shown the lifetime inside the museum with an amazing infographic design so that's why I say anyone can understand what happened in the world. Anyone can understand what happened the sell and buy the economy in the world. Also, which company related and which business. So immediately all the kind of information then visualize one moment. It's very beautiful. So that means I think he's in a kind of neutral position, but the way to he just work is very radical. Because those kind of his ideas and infographic world, how analysis, how interpreted the world, and it's quite, you know, and impressive and for me. Because and lastly, what he said, because many traders come to see his work,
mm-hmm.
so one by one. So they're emotionally affected by the images. So that's why I thought that it's a circulation, because sometimes artworks and those kind of outcome and the presentation affected the trader's mind. So that means that trade has been changing. So it's quite interesting. This is a real radical affection. So this is one thing. The other one is an artist, Kohei Nawa. He's a sculptor, and he just kind of end of the 30s years old. But then he just formed, a factory. And like Andy Warhol factory named Sandwich. It's not only going to make a sculpture painting, and he designed some of the space, and also he worked with Comedy Garrison, he also proposed a lot of the architectural city planning project.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's really growing. So that what is interesting things, and two things, and he just using new materials, transform the new materiality, and means, the artists who just grow up the media environment, they have peculiar ideas of what the mediality, what the physicality is. Jorge now is really inventing the new languages, what the materials, also what the materiality is going to be, what the message, also what the conceptual frame. So, mm-hmm. which is quite interesting. So secondly, and he had some certain ideas about the very organic systems, because when he proposed the city planning, and also he designed the kind of like a theater, also like in the buildings and everything very organically and connected, and not only architecture program, also those kind of cultural program be together. So that means it's transformation also also the very organic kind of connection ideas. It's a quite new kind of concept, because it's not legitimate languages. It's more kind of practice, but it works very well.
Mm-hmm.
So that also he's going to be leading artist to not only kind of art world, also as a general kind of creative cultural business. So mm-hmm. this is my point.
Okay, and I would like to comment you this sentence.
Mm-hmm.
Knowledge doesn't come from the West no more.
Because yes.
I was also reading the statement you had for the Biennial of Sharjah, and I know that this is quite important to you, so I would like you to comment on this.
Yeah, because, this is, I just also, it is quite easy to just to quote my upcoming exhibition,
okay.
and it's New Sensorium, and, title is Exiting Failure of the Modernization, Exiting the Failure of Modernization, because most difficult things, most problematic things about Western modernization is too much focus on the subject. Subject means somebody's individual subjectivity.
Mm-hmm.
But then it's more importantly, and it's not only kind of focused on one individual subjectivity, more kind of important to make a new relations and human, non-human, also between and materials and non-materials.
Mm-hmm.
That means sometimes human can be connected to animals, and a human can be connected to an environment, human connected to be a kind of robot. That means very flexible idea what the subjectivity is, because we are kind of the part of the world, part of the environment, because it's not only if you just focused on the only kind of subjectivities, that goes me very human centralization,
mm-hmm.
because that means a very egoistic kind of structure, because that's why it's those kind of leading and modernization led by those kind of Western and subjective and human and oriented direction to cause a lot of problem. So this is also global warming, also lot of the kind of the, you know, terrorist attack, you know, and those and those, because it's not only kind of the conflict and two fundamentalists, it's more kind of deeply rooted and what the problem with modernization caused. This is my point, because you know, and the artists are coming up the from Asia, also, you know, Arab, and which is mean global south, mm-hmm. and which I selected in Sharjah, because this is very common, you know, and structure which they have, because they are very much concerned about what they have and originally and pre-modern means, and they are thinking about, you know, deeply rooted again to those kinds of, you know, consciousness field which used to and people shared. It's not only that, because they are also very critical and opinion about you know, and current situation, but they just bring up their own kind of, you know, feedback to the pre-modern time and cultural legacy, bring to contemporary and kind of the, you know, and interpretation, also contemporary formation. This is an it's a quite common, you know, an element which I, the artist which I invited.